रहा, पता नहीं है कौन। ओल्ड सिटी हॉल
सोफिया।
Oh goodness. Declaration of American Independence, July 1776.
All right, Benjamin Franklin. Things here. The oldest burying ground in Boston is right there. 1630. We call that King's Chapel Burying Ground because it's next to King's Chapel. That actually starts out as an Anglican church, later becomes a Unitarian church, still a Unitarian church today. Where we're standing, this is the site of America's very first public school, built here in 1635 to provide free public education for boys and boys only. That school still exists today, and it's one of the best public high schools in this country. You have to take a test to get in. You have to take 4 years of Latin to graduate. If you graduate from that school, you can pretty much pick the college of your choice. Boston Latin School has provided free public education for boys here in America since 1635. And the girls, well, we got to attend in 1972. When Title IX was passed, giving us equal opportunities to the boys. 1635 for boys, 1972 for us. From the school that was built right here, three most famous graduates, Charles Bulfinch, the architect, John Hancock graduated from this school, Sam Adams graduated from this school. Most famous dropout is this guy, Benjamin Franklin, yeah. He went to school right here, but he dropped out as a teenager to work in his brother's print shop, which was on the next block over. He runs away to Philadelphia, and he opens up his own print shop, and that's where he becomes the Renaissance man you're familiar with. But what I want you to know about Ben Franklin is, of our founding fathers, he is the only one who works on and signs the four biggest documents to the birth of this nation. One, he works on the subcommittee with Thomas Jefferson to write the Declaration of Independence, signs it. Two, he negotiated the alliance with France. And without France, we would have had our butts kicked. England would have destroyed the 13 colonies. We need France militarily. We need France financially. Benjamin Franklin made that happen. And France didn't do it because they loved us. They just hated England. Oh, so much more, yeah. Benjamin Franklin also negotiated the peace treaty between what is now the new United States of America and England. And he also worked on and signed the document that established the frameworks for the way our government works. And here in America, we follow the United States Constitution. So of our founding fathers, this is the only guy who works on all four of the biggest documents to the birth of this nation. So even though he's a dropout, he deserves the statue. Here we go.